Hello students, welcome to this new lecture of the Laws of Motion chapter. So we have discussed a number of points which are dealing to this chapter. Now we are going to proceed the next part of this chapter. But before that, it is necessary to revise some important part. So in the last lecture, we have discussed about the acceleration, positive, negative and the zero acceleration. After that, we have seen about the graphs. Means last time we have seen the velocity time graph for the uniform velocity. So that part we will just revise in very short impact of time. So suppose this is the x-axis as we know. This is y-axis as we know. So this will be zero. So we are on the x-axis, we are taking the time. We are taking time on the x-axis and we are taking the velocity, it will be velocity on the y-axis. So this much we have covered. You should not have any confusion in your mind. We are just plotted the y-axis and x-axis. On the x-axis we have taken the time, on the y-axis we have taken the velocity. This is V for velocity. Now we have to draw the graph for the uniform velocity. So first of all, it is necessary to understand what mean by the uniform velocity. Uniform velocity means the constant velocity. The velocity will not be changed for the different impact of times. Suppose for the 5 second, the velocity is 14 km per hour, or after 10 second, the velocity will be remain 40 km per hour. After 1 hour, the velocity will be 40 km per hour. So this is a constant velocity for different time intervals, and that is nothing but our uniform velocity. And we have to draw the graph for it. Now simply, we will take the simple values to draw the graph for the uniform velocity. Suppose I will take the seconds, the time in second for 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have taken up to 6. Now I will take the values on the y-axis. It is for the velocity which will be in the kilometer per hour. Suppose this is 10 km per hour, 20 km per hour. Then after that 30 km per hour, 40 km per hour, 50 km per hour, and this is 60 km per hour. So these are the different values of the velocities on the y-axis. Now suppose I have took the value of 60. I took the value of 60. Then if I draw the line like this, then what does it indicate? It indicates that for when the 1 second was when 1 second for the 4 second, the velocity value of velocity is same. It is 60 km per hour. For the second, it is also same, 60 km per hour. There is no any value change. It is not 50, 40, 30, 20 or 10. For the every second, if you see, the value of velocity is 60 km per hour. Means the velocity has remained constant. The velocity has remained constant. We will take one example. Suppose this is the time interval of second and time interval of 5th second. If you see, for the second, the value was 60 km per hour, and for the 5th second also the value was 60 km per hour. So from this graph we can understand the uniform velocity is the velocity which is constant for the different interval of times. That is the uniform velocity, and this is the graph for the velocity time graph for the uniform velocity. So this is the simplest one graph. I will explain one more time. You have to draw the x and y axis as you know, and we have to take the time on the x axis and the velocity on the y axis. And for your sake of your convenience, you can take the 1, 2, 3 second in the multiple of which will be the time interval will be 1 second. I have taken 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And for your sake of your convenience, again you can take the 10 km per hour. 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. After this, you have took the value and you have to decide the any one fixed value of the velocity which will be constant for every second with respect to the time. So this is how we can draw the graph for the uniform velocity for the velocity and time graph. Now after that, we have discussed now we will see the next part of this chapter. Now we are going to learn the three equations of motions. First of all, I will tell you what are those three equations of motion. So first one is V is equal to U plus AT. This is the first equation. Then second one is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And third one is V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. So these are the three equations of motions on which there will be the problems in your exam. You have to solve the problems based on these equations. Now we know that these equations can be used to solve the any values of initial velocity, final velocity, let it be for the time, let it be to calculate the displacement or for the acceleration. But we need to know that how this equation has been derived, how this equation were prepared or how these equations were formed. It is necessary to know this detail, in detail. So I will give you the exact derivations in very simple language, so you won't be able to forget. I will tell you the simplest language to keep in mind the derivation of this three of the equation. So out of that, first of all, we will see the derivation for the first equation, V is equal to U plus AT. First of all, we will see this equation. Now, for this derivation, I have drawn a diagram here. As you can see, this is the x-axis and y-axis. So as usual, we have taken the time on the x-axis, you can see, and I have taken the velocity on the y-axis. This is the velocity, this is the time. Now you can see here is you can see quadrilateral has been formed there, then the trapezium has been formed and one triangle also you can see. So likewise, after time we will use that quadrilateral, trapezium and the triangle. Now as you can see here, first of all we will see the definition of acceleration. What is the definition of acceleration? So acceleration is nothing but the difference between initial velocity and the final velocity with respect to the time. I will remind you, the acceleration is nothing but V minus U by T. This is the simplest form, V minus U by T. Now, as we know, so this is the U, this is initial velocity, this is V, this is final velocity on the y-axis. So at the initial velocity the point is D, at the final velocity the point is C. And this is the time, the value of time is T for at the point of A, and for the value of final velocity V, the value is the point is B. And this is the values, or this is the points we have to use. Now acceleration is nothing but V minus U by T. I hope you can see this very clearly. Acceleration is equal to V minus U by T. Now as you can say, V means what? Final velocity. O to V. Okay, this V means O to V. So what is distance? This is OC. This is C point. So instead of V, we will write OC. Okay. So we will write OC. Minus, here is point U. So U again, the point is D. So instead of U, I can write OD. I will write here OD. Okay. Now the value for time will be as it is, and this is your acceleration. What I have done? First of all, I have written the formula of the acceleration. A is equal to v minus u by t, and as you can see, instead of this v, I have written oc here. Instead of this u, I have used the od here. So now the remaining values I have kept as it is. The t will be as it is and the acceleration will be as it is. Now as you can see in the diagram, this is the oc minus od. What will happen if this od is subtracted from the oc? I will tell you one more time. This is the od I have subtracted from the oc, then what will remain? It will remain only cd. So a is equal to cd upon t. So I can write cd is equal to at. cd is equal to at. This is the, suppose, equation number a, or equation number you can give any, or you can just keep this value in your mind. Now what we have to do now, the next thing is, what is b? I will draw the line from here. What is b? B means, b is equal to, this is the b. B is nothing but summation of ab plus ae. Okay, this entire b, this b is equal to ab plus ae. So ab plus ae. Now what is the value of ab? You can see here, the value of ab is v. The value of ab is what? You can write the value for the ab, or I will tell you, this ab, this distance of ab is parallel to the this cd. As you can see, the distance between a and b is exact distance between c and b. Okay, so instead of this ab, I will write the cd here. Have you got why I have took the cd instead of ab? Because the distance between a and b, ab, is exactly equal to cd. So I can write cd instead of ab. Now the ae. The ae means, what is the distance between ae? A is nothing but this is the t. You can see here, because the distance between O to E is t, and this will be also t. So, or I will tell you one important point. This AE, this is the AE distance, so it is also parallel to the OD. As you can see, this AE is also parallel to the OD. So OD is distance u. You can see here, OD is distance u, so AE will be also u. Okay, so instead of this AE, I can write or first of all, I will write the OD. Now this BE means what? This OD, this OC is V. We know the distance of OC is equal to V, so this BE will be also is equal to V. So I can write here, I will write B one more time for your understanding. Now I will put the value. The B means, this is the B. So the distance B is exactly equal to OC, and this distance is nothing but our final velocity, that is B. So instead of B, I will write the B. Now the value of CD we have derived here. The value of CD is equal to AT. So I will write here AT. And the value of OD, this is the OD, and its value is U. You can see here. So this is the U. And for the correction, we can write V is equal to U plus AT. So this is our first equation of motion on which there will be examples or the problems will be there. Some of the students might have got this, But those students who still not have got or still not understand, I will just revise in very short impact of time. First of all, whenever there will be the question in the exam that derive the equation for the velocity and time. Velocity and time. So first of all, you have to draw the x and y axis. Then you have to indicate the first initial velocity, final velocity. Then there will be at the initial velocity point is d and the final velocity c. Like and the time will be OE is equal to t. So like this you have to draw the graph. Then after that you have to give the acceleration. You have to give the formula for the acceleration is first of all you have to write the formula of the acceleration. So I have written acceleration is equal to difference between final velocity minus initial velocity with respect to the time. Now the values of this formula I will put into this formula. Now v is nothing but where is v? If you seen the graph, the v is distance between O to C. So instead of this v, I have written OC. Instead of this v, I have written OC because this OC is nothing but v. So instead of this v, I have written OC. So again minus v u. So u is here. So u is nothing but the distance between OD. So instead of this u, I have written OD. Upon time as it is and the acceleration will be as it is. So as you can see the OC minus OD, this OC minus OD or this OD minus OC, then there will be only CD will be remain. I will tell you, some of you may still having the confusion about this problem. You have to subtract the OD from this entire OC. If you just neglect OD from the entire OC, then there will be only CD will be the part remain. So that's what I have written. OC minus OD is equal to CD. So this T is in the denominator. When it comes to this side of the equality sign, so it will be AT. So CD is equal to AT, and this will be our first equation. Or first equation means that is only one part or the sub part of this derivation. Now we have to think about this BE. So this BE is nothing but it is the summation of AB plus AE. As you can say, this AB plus AE, okay, the two parts AE and AB is equal to this entire BE. So I have written is BE is equal to AB plus AE. Now if you observe the graph, this AB is equal to this CD. This AB is equal to CD. So instead of this AB, I have written CD. Okay. And after that, plus this AE is equal to OD. This AE is equal to OD. So CD plus OD will be there. B is equal to CD plus OD will be there. So one more thing if you observe, if you see BE, this entire BE is equal to OC. Entire BE is equal to OC. And the OC means the V. So instead of this BE, I have written the V. So V will be, and now the CD will, what is the value of CD? CD is nothing but, see, you can see here CD, we have calculated here. This is the value of CD, it is 80. So instead of this CD, I have written 80. Plus this OD, this is the OD, it is nothing but the U. So I will return U. So the equation will be V is equal to U plus AT. And this is nothing but the equation of velocity and time. On the basis of graph, we have derived. Okay. So this is the first equation of motion. Now after that, we will see the second equation of motion, which is S is equal to ut plus half at square. We are going to see its derivation now. I hope you guys have understood this entire graph and the derivation. If you have any problem, then you can see this part again. So you will get it very easily because I have explained in a very simplest language. Now, as you can see here, I hope the graph I have drawn, you have got it, at least 90% you have got the graph, how I have drawn this graph. Now, if you observe the graph, so there is one quadrangle is there. There is one quadrangle. Which quadrangle is that? That quadrangle is DOEB. You can see DOEB. For sake of your convenience, I will just mark the chalk over that quadrangle. DOEB. So this is the quadrangle. So we have to calculate the entire area of that quadrangle. Which quadrangle? I will explain one more. I will tell you DOEB. This is the quadrangle, and I want to calculate the area of that quadrangle. So I will write the S. The S is the sign we are using to indicate the displacement. So this quadrangle can be area of this quadrangle can be given. This if you observe again, this quadrangle is consist of one rectangle and one triangle. Okay. This DOEB is the quadrangle. So there is one rectangle and one triangle in there. Which rectangle? DOEA is the rectangle, and ABC or DAB is the one triangle. So if I want the area of the entire quadrangle, so I have to make the summation of this area of this rectangle and area of this triangle. Then I will get the entire area of the quadrangle. So I will write S is equal to this area of this quadrangle is equal to area of rectangle DOEA plus area of triangle, this area of this triangle ABD. So this I will tell you one more time, the area of this entire quadrangle DOEB is equal to area of this rectangle plus area of this triangle. So I will put the value now. Now if you know the what is the formula for the area of rectangle, the multiplication of two adjacent sides, which can be given as the area of rectangle. So if you see this rectangle DOEA, so adjacent sides are AE and OE. If you can see AE and OE, so I will write instead of area of rectangle DOEA, I will write AE into OE. AE into OE. This plus sign will be as it is. Plus, now I want the area of triangle ABD. This is ABD. This is area of triangle. Now, ABD means not the ABD Villiers, as the IPL season is going on. You don't have to involve your mind when you are studying. So, jokes apart, I want the area of triangle ABD. So area of the triangle is, what is the formula for the area of triangle? So the formula for the area of triangle is half base into height. So what is the base of this triangle? The base of this triangle is AD and height is AB. So I will write half base is AD and height is AB. Height is AB. So this much I have written. Now you can see AE means what? AE means this is the AE, okay, and this AE is equal to OD and OD is U. So instead of AE I will write U. Have you got how I have written U? So U will be AE into OE is there. So instead of this AE, AE is exactly equal to OD and OD means U. So I have written here U, and into OE, into again OE. OE means the time. So it is nothing but the T. As you can see, it is the T. So I will write here T. Plus this half as it is into AD. Now where is AD? AD is here, as you can see here. AD. AD means this OE is equal to AD, as you can see here. This OE is exactly equal to AD, and this OE means T. So AD will be also T. So it is T. Into this is AB. Where is AB? AB is here, and which is exactly equal to the CD. AB is here, and which is exactly equal to the CD. And in the previous equation, you may have remembering that AD, what was the value of CD? The value of CD was 80. So instead of this AB, I can directly write the 80. So I will write the 80 here. I will write the 80 here. Now you can see, we will make the math simplifications. This is U into T, it will be UT, okay? Plus this half as it is, this T and this T will be T square. So I can write A into T square, A into T square, or you can simply you can write, okay, A into T square. So S will be, this is the entire area of quadrangle, which will be if I want to write this formula in other form, I can write S is equal to UT plus, or you can keep this formula of this form only, S is equal to UT plus half AT square. So this is the second equation of motion second equation of motion on which there will be the problems will be there. I will explain in very short impact of time. I have taken the same graph, okay? I have taken the same graph, and if you observe the closely, then there is one quadrangle. Which quadrangle? DOEB is the quadrangle. So I want the area of that quadrangle. So in that area of that quadrangle, there is two more shapes are there. Which, this is the rectangle and triangle. DOEA is the rectangle, and ABD is triangle. So if I make the summation the areas of rectangle and triangle, then I will get the area of quadrangle. So I have written area of rectangle DOEA plus area of triangle ABD. So area of rectangle means the multiplication of adjacent sides, okay? So this is AE. You can see AE into OE. So value of AE is, this is AE, which is exactly equal to OD, having the value U. So I will write here U into OE. This is the OE having the value T. So I have written T plus sign as it is, half will be as it is into AD. So this is the AD, which is exactly equal to the OE having the value T. So I will write here T into the AB. This is the AB. So AB is exactly equal to CD, and the CD, the value of CD we have derived in the first equation, the value of CD is 80. So I will write here 80. Then after that, you have to make the max simplifications. So U into T will be UT plus half will be as it is into T into T, T square, and A will be there. So half AT square will be there. So S is equal to UT plus half AT square is our second equation of motion. I hope, student, you have got these two equations very easily, because I have told you in very simplest language. Even if you have any problems, so you can watch this video again and again. So you will be learn very easily, and you will be you won't be able to forget this. Never. So you will remind it very easily. So if you have any problems, then you can just contact with me, or you can just make the comment in the comment box. So I will solve your doubts. I will clear your doubts. So for today's lecture, it is enough for today's lecture. Now the next part of this law of motion chapter, we will see in the next lecture. Thank you so much.